Welcome to all. Myself Jyothimani from EC department from M. Kumarasamy College of Engineering. Now I am going to explain about oscillators. So oscillator is a circuit, so that is used to generate an oscillations. So normally oscillators used in some various applications. So it's like of an amplifier. Oscillator is a circuit, without giving an input it produces an output. But if you are taking an amplifier, so amplifier, if you are using an input, so with the help of input it produces an output. Oscillator is a circuit which basically act as a generator, generating the output signal which oscillate with constant amplitude and desired frequency. Oscillator is nothing but without giving an input it produces an output, so it uses an positive feedback. Oscillator which uses positive feedback, so whereas the amplifier uses a negative feedback. So in this oscillator having an various types, so consider one oscillator that will be where it will be applicable one. So for example, in a FM, consider one FM FM radio station. So in that FM radio station, so in various frequencies we are appearing in various FM. For example, if you are taking an one Koda FM in, so it is working under 100.5. in some other FM also we are having. So in that, how the oscillator will be applicable means, so first in that FM station, so there are some free, they are speaking, so that send from your one station to another station. If they are in a Kodaikanal, so it will be reaching in all over ranges in that corresponding frequencies. So in that, the tuning of the frequencies in that FM, for a tuning operations this oscillator will be applicable. Tuning of the frequencies from your 188 to from 120 MHz, likewise the frequency variation the oscillator will be applicable one. So here they are speaking something, so that will be modulated, then that send it to your destination point. So here modulation is applicable one. So modulation is nothing but, so when a low frequency is added with your high frequency signal, so the low frequency signal is sent to your sender, then that will reach to the receiver, means we cannot obtain a original frequency. So if the signal is in weak signal mid, in a receiver it cannot reach in a desired signal. So that's what we are using an oscillator. So in that low frequency signal, we have added an oscillator circuit that is called a carrier frequency. So our original signal is added to your carrier frequency signal. That carrier frequency signal is generated by using an oscillator. We are having an various types of oscillators, having RC phase shift oscillators, crystal oscillators, then Armstrong oscillators and local oscillators. So we are having various types of oscillators. In that, depending upon the applications, the oscillator will be added. So here the low frequency signal is added with your high frequency signal, so that is called modulation. So modulation is nothing but changing the carrier frequency in accordance with your original signal, changing the carrier signal in accordance with the message signal, so that generate an modulating signal. That's called as a modulating signal. Then this modulating signal is again sent through a channel, then again that will be recorded by using a demodulated circuit, is also called as detector circuit. If you are using various detector circuit, example if you are having various types of modulations, AM modulation, FM modulation and then PM modulation. So AM modulation is nothing but changing your amplitude of the carrier frequency in accordance with your message signal. Our message signal is a low signal and our carrier signal is a high frequency signal. So in that carrier signal only this oscillator is added. Through the oscillator the carrier frequency signal is generated. Then the amplitude modulation is a changing an amplitude of the carrier signal in accordance with the message signal. Then if you are taking an FM signal, that is FM modulation, using frequency modulation, the changing a frequency of the carrier signal in accordance with the message signal. Then as well as for a phase modulation, the phase of your carrier signal is varied in accordance with your message signal, that generate this three type of modulation, generate and modulating signal. Then if you are using an detectors, for if you are using AM modulation means having some square law detectors, Then if you are using FO modulations or a PM modulation, if you are using it, some other director circuits. So in AM itself having some SSB modulation, VSB and then DSB modulations. So in that using balanced modulation and likewise having various detector circuit. So using that detector circuit, we require our original signal. So our original signal is required that will reach to our destination receiver. So this is a concept of a modulation. In that place, this oscillator will be employed for generating high frequency signal. This oscillator will be applicable one, as well as for a in an FM station, the tuning of frequencies, this oscillator will be used. Changing the frequencies, this oscillator will be used for this amplifiers, taking amplifiers and oscillator. This will be used in some of the small circuits. So in this oscillator, we are going to apply in some small applications. So that's why this is called as a generator. This oscillator is called as a generator that generating an output signal which oscillates with constant amplitude and desired frequencies. For changing your frequencies, the oscillation will be varied depending upon the circuits. So the types of oscillator is according to this having in four types. So we are classifying into four types according to the waveform generator and according to the fundamental mechanism involved. And negative resistance oscillator and the last one is a feedback oscillator. So according to the waveform generator, we are having in two types under this. So one is that sinusoidal oscillator and relaxation oscillator. So sinusoidal oscillator is nothing but it generates an voltage or current generated simultaneously. It produces an sine waves. So it produces a sine waves like this. So consider this is amplitude. So this is your amplitude. Then this is your voltage. So it produces a sinusoidal output that is in a sine wave or cos wave, anything else. So it's called as a sustained oscillations. So it comes under your sinusoidal oscillator. Then it produces a non-sinusoidal outputs also. That is called square waves. It produces square wave, then pulse, then rectangular waves. So then spike waves. So these waves are also called as a non-sinusoidal waves. So it is a type of a relaxation oscillator. So the oscillator means it is a positive feedback. It generates only a positive feedback. Then without giving an input through this feedback, it given an input to your amplifier circuit. So then amplifier and then feedback circuit that produce an output. Okay. So then next one is according to our fundamental mechanisms used. So in the presence of negative resistance as well as positive feedback oscillators, using a positive feedback, it will generate an oscillations. Then next one is a third type according to the frequency generator. So depending upon the frequency generation, we have classified and six types of oscillator. So that is, first one is an audio frequency oscillator. So that's in a range of from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. Normally we are using in an audio frequencies. So then radio frequency oscillator. So 20 kilohertz to 30 megahertz, it will be applicable in 20 kilohertz to 30 megahertz. Then next one is in very high frequency oscillators, that is in a frequency range of 30 megahertz to 300 megahertz. Then ultra high frequency oscillator, so 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz, the frequency ranges from 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz. So this is applicable in your televisions. So in our televisions, you are using UHF and then VHF frequency range. So it is under the modulation of your VSB modulation. Then this radio frequency oscillator, it is in a FM. This is used in your FM modulation, and audio frequency oscillators is used in your AM modulation. Then microwave oscillators. microwave oscillator, the frequency ranges from 3 gigahertz to 30 gigahertz. And then millimeter wave oscillator, so that is in a range of your 30 gigahertz to above 30 gigahertz, so simply are called as a 30 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. The next two type is that according to the type of circuit used. So having type of circuit used, another having two types. So one is that LC oscillator and another one is called RC oscillator. According to the type of circuit used, one is LC oscillator, then another one is that RC oscillator. So taking the concept of the LC oscillator means in that you're having an amplifier circuit. So normally having amplifier as consider one CE amplifier. So normally CE amplifier means you're having RC resistance. So consider this transistor. So one CE based transistor. So here having an R1, so collector resistance. So consider a one circuit, amplifier circuit, CE amplifier. Here having base resistance, that is R1 and then R2. Consider this one base resistance R1 and then R2 base resistance, and then here collector resistance is called simply RC. Then you are giving a supply here, so plus VCC, either in a plus 10 volt or plus 12 volt. Okay, VCC you are giving supply. Then here having an bypass capacitance RE, sorry, bypass resistance, then bypass capacitance CE. So then I'm making a ground connection. So this is our normally our amplifier circuit. So this is called a CE amplifier. So this is our base, then collector and then emitter. So this is normally our amplifier circuit. So in this we are adding our oscillator circuit. Okay, anyway, for any LC oscillator or in a term of your RC oscillator. So if you are adding an LC oscillator means, then in that presence only of inductance and then capacitance. It have only the presence of inductance and capacitance. So in case of your adding an RC oscillator means, so the resistance and then capacitance is present. Resistance. Here the resistance and then capacitance is present across this circuit. So here considering I am a RC, so C and then R. So only the presence of C and then R resistance. So that create a, here having an three types of RC network is connected, that is in cascade form. So that you are simply called as a ladder type networks. That is simply called as a ladder type networks. So here in this, so how it will be acted as an oscillator. So how it will be acted as an oscillator means, so it produces an 180 degree phase shift. Your amplifier is produced an 180 degree phase shift, as well as your oscillator circuit produces an 180 degree phase shift. So total around the oscillator is a 360 degree phase shift. Then here I am taking an LC oscillator concept. According to the type of circuit used, having two types, one is LC oscillator, another one is that RC oscillator. In that LC oscillator, consider in LC, consider one switch across your LC circuit, okay, L and then C. So here having an C inductance, sorry, L, and then in capacitance C. So this is called our LC oscillator circuit. This is C, the term presence of in that circuit, the elements are presence L and then C. So across that we connecting in one switch. Here you are connecting in one switch, in that oscillator you are connecting across that one switch, C and then L. So that is called as, is also called as a tank circuit. So normally what is the use of tank circuit means, that is used to store. It is used to store your frequencies, that is used the purpose of store. So here the C and then L. So C is normally when a voltage is paused here, so when the current flow, when they are generating a current through the switch you are connecting, so we are for a pause your current here, I, we are passing a current I here. Now the switch is in open. Here can say the switch is open. So there is no current flow here in this L and then C in this tank circuit, in LC oscillator circuit. So now the switch is closed. So now we are considering switch is closed. So here consider switch is closed. So they having a current flow. We are applying a current here. So the current flow in this circuit. So here the L and then C. The current is flow here. So normally the current is flow means what is the use of this L and then C is mean that. So L is used for store the energy as well as C is also store in energy. So both L and C store the energy. Here L and C energy is stored. In that L, that store energy in magnetic field, that is in form of a magnetic field, and C store energy in electrostatic field. C is electrostatic field, store energy in electrostatic field, and L is store energy in magnetic field. So the current is paused here. So this the inductance across the current is zero because. So here the reactance of inductance is XC. So normally the reactance of inductance XL is equal to, the inductance of reactance of the inductance XL is equal to 2 pi FL. The reactance of inductance is 2 pi FL. So here the frequency across this inductance is zero. So F is equal to zero here, our FL. Is equal to zero when we are applying a current. So the reactance across this inductance is our FL is zero here, the reactance. So here applying the zero here. So what is our reactance? So it is equal to 2 pi into FL, then 2 pi, the FL is zero, the frequency is zero. So normally this XL is equal to zero. So our reactance across the inductance is zero. Then for here, find the reactance across this capacitance. So the reactance of the capacitance X is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. This is the reactance of your capacitance. So therefore is the frequency across the circuit is in zero. The FC is in zero. So apply this here. Then X is equal to infinity. You are getting 1 by 2 pi FC is equal to zero. So zero into anything is 0. So 1 divided by 0 is called as an infinite. So X is equal to infinite. So it creates a short circuit here. So infinite means having and some larger values. So it creates short circuit here. It creates a short circuit here. So the current flow. They're having a current flow, but inductance acted as an open circuit. So there is a no current across this inductance. Because our XL is equal to 0, reactant is 0, so it acted as an, our inductance is acted as an open circuit, so the current flow is 0. But for your capacitance, you are finding the reactance as an infinite, so it forms a short circuit. So always short circuit means it flows a current. So the current is flow. Normally the current is flow means what is that use of the capacitance is, normally it act as an charging and discharging. It acts the principle of charging and the discharging. So first the current is paused here, it charged, then after that it will be discharged. After discharging, it releases the current here. Then in that circuit, the current will be released. So the inductance also charged. So the current flow is there. Then it produces an oscillator output. It produces for that particular current or voltage, anything else. If you're applying a current or voltage, so for a particular current, it produces some oscillations. So it produces an oscillator circuit. So normally here it produces an oscillation output is like this, somewhat increased or an decreased, that is you are called over damped output or under damped output. If you are connecting LC oscillator to your amplifier circuit, it produces an output. That output is in a form of an either a over damped or in a under damped, not in a constant one. If you are not getting a constant oscillation, that will be changed one. So we are getting in form of a over damped. So this is called over damped output. So or otherwise under damped output. Under damped output means the value is decreased one. The frequency of the sine wave output. Here I am considering a sine wave output, that will be decreased one. So we are getting over damped or then output. Under damped output. So far we are not getting a constant output. So for that reason we are add an feedback circuit here. We have to include a positive feedback, that is beta. The feedback factor we are considering as a beta, so positive feedback. In this circuit, we are adding a feedback circuit. So positive, we are giving a positive feedback circuit to this circuit. So feedback is nothing but the output of this oscillator circuit is given an input to your amplifier circuit. So then the amplifier produces output is in a constant. So depending upon the feedback factor, it will provide the constant output or overdamped or the underdamped. So we should decide a feedback factor value. So we should give feedback factor some constant values. Suppose if you are giving an high value of beta means, so then the output is also varied. So that's what, so constant feedback factor we have to introduce to produce a constant output. So that is the reason of we are using a feedback factor in this circuit. So suppose if you are using a negative feedback here in this oscillator, if you are using negative feedback means it decreases the output, it cannot be added. So for example, already having an some 100 value, so already having an some 100 value, so in that but if you want to generate output in a 150, for a 150 range only we are getting our constant output value. So if you are using a negative feedback means at a feedback factor of minus 50, if you are considering feedback factor is equal to 50, so in that oscillator circuit adding a negative feedback means that decrease minus 50, negative feedback means minus 50. So 100, already having an 100 value, then 100 minus 50 is called, what is it, it will be decreased only, you are getting 50 value only. So the value is decreased one, we cannot get your constant output. So for that reason, if you are adding an, we are using a positive feedback with a factor, we have to decide the feedback factor. So in this, for example, in this I say 50. So in the beta is and 50, you are taking feedback factor values of 50, then that will be added to your amplifier circuit. So already in the amplifier considering 100, so 100 plus 50 is 150. So if we are getting a constant output as an 150. So that is the reason to you are using a positive feedback here in this oscillator circuits. So that is the LC oscillator form. Then next we are going to see about, now I am going to explain about RC phase shift oscillator in that RC oscillator circuits. So this is a phase shift oscillator. The circuit is an RC phase shift oscillator diagram. This diagram shows that RC phase shift oscillator. So in this we are having an amplifier circuit R, and then this R, this 2R represents your base resistance, and this is your collector resistance, and this are bypass resistance and then capacitance across your emitter terminal. So RA, and then see here it reduces in biasing. So always the amply transistor producing and biasing, in that you are connecting a CR RC phase shift here, RC phase shift in that RC oscillator. So normally RC oscillator means having two types, having RC phase shift oscillator and then Wien bridge oscillator. So RC phase shift is nothing but that shifting your phase of the output. So in this circuit, this amplifier produces a 180 degree phase shift. This amplifier producing a 180 degree phase shift. So as well as this RC network in this C R and CR, this three circuit is called as an RC oscillator. So from up to this is an oscillator circuit, that is RC phase shift oscillator. So from here, this is called as an, from this range to this, this is an our CE amplifier. Here we are using, I am using a CE amplifier circuit. So this amplifier produce 180 degree phase shift, as well as here this RC circuit, each network producing a 60 degree phase shift. So the reason is that, so consider one simple RC, okay, C here, considering C, and then so I am simply taking an R and C network. In this circuit, connecting an 3 RC network in ladder format, that is in form of cascade. So I am considering here C, and then simply I am taking an 1 RC network. Here the capacitance is working in a leading and the R is working in in phase. Okay, normally this L and C are taking. So I am going to draw the vector diagram for this one. So always the C is and leads the voltage and R is in phase. in phase, working in phase. If you are applying voltage to this circuit, then C is a leads the voltage and R is in phase. So now I draw the vector diagram for this one. So consider, so the voltage across the resistance is called as VR. Voltage across the resistance is called VR and voltage across the capacitance is called VC. Voltage across the capacitance is VC and voltage across the resistance is VR. We are taking in x-axis and then y-axis. Okay, so always the voltage across resistance is in phase, so that's why I'm representing in phase region, that is here zero, so in phase region. Then voltage across the capacitor, it always leads, so that's why I'm taking in a y-axis. Okay, so here, so we are applying voltage, so this is our output voltage V. This is our getting our output voltage for a sine output. So in that sine means having in some voltage. Through that voltage it produces an output, so consider this is our output voltage V. So if you are using an 60 degree, if you are using an 60 degree angle here, 60 degree angle, so changing this angle, changing the frequency of this one, changing the frequency of this one, our voltage will be varied. For a constant output variations, if you are using 60 degree. So if you are using 90 degree, 120 or 100 degree, anything else, but our output is not getting constant value, not getting a sine, this sine output, that is in constant amplitude. So that's what we are using, fixed 60 degree. We are changing this angle, we are getting our output is also varied. Changing our angle values, our output is also varied. So that's why we are fixing our 60 degree at a constant. So we are getting our constant sustained output oscillation. So this is a vector diagram for our RC phase shift oscillator. Then move on to the concept of RC phase shift oscillator. So each and every oscillator is having some conditions. Each and every oscillator is having a condition. So having a two set of condition, through this condition only it will set as does in oscillator or not a oscillators. So if one circuit is acted as an oscillator, means it satisfy the two condition. So the conditions are, first one is, it's simply called as Bergeson criterion. We simply called as Bergeson criterion. So the total phase shift across this loop is 0 degree or 360 degree. Total phase shift across this loop is 0 degree or 360 degree. This is the first condition. And second condition is modulus A beta is equal to 1. That is modulus A beta is equal to 0. So first condition and then second condition. So first condition is 0 degree. The total phase shift is across the loop is 0 degree or 360 degree. 0 degree or 360 degree. Then our second condition for our oscillation is modulus A beta is equal to 1. So that is the amplitude of the the product of amplitude, the gain, amplifier gain and a feedback factor should be at 1. So the magnitude of the loop gain must be unity. More or less A beta is equal to 1. Then the total phase shift across the loop is 0 degree or 360 degree. So the total phase shift around the loop, as a signal proceeds from an input through amplifier, feedback network back to input again, completing a loop is precisely 0 degree or 360 degree. So simply I say it as the total phase shift across the loop is 0 degree or 360 degree. Then second one is the magnitude of the product of amplifier and the feedback factor should be 1. This is a condition for one circuit is called as an oscillator. This simply we state that Bergeson criterion. So we are having various types of oscillator, that is Armstrong oscillator, then crystal oscillators, then RC phase shift oscillator, Wien bridge oscillator and LC oscillator. Under that LC having two types, so one is Hartley oscillator and then Kolbitz oscillators. So in this, the each and every oscillator have to be satisfy this condition, then only we are calling as an oscillator. So that is the condition of our oscillator. So here the magnitude I am saying is an A beta, modulus A beta is equal to 1. So through this, is, I am saying as in modulus A beta is equal to 1. So, here, considering modulus A beta is greater than 1, our modulus A beta is greater than 1, is called as a growing type oscillation. It simply states the growing type oscillation. So here, our output, here I am example like considering a sine wave output. So in this, the amplitude of the signal should be increased to 1. So it's simply called as a growing type oscillation. So when this type of oscillation will be produced, it means at the condition of modulus A beta is greater than 1, our the product of your amplifier gain as well as our feedback factor, the value should be greater than 1 means. So at that time, it having a growing type of oscillation. The oscillator will produce output as a growing type oscillation. So same likewise, our modulus A beta is equal to 1 means that produce a sustained oscillation. So it is called simply are calling as a perfect oscillation, modulus A beta is equal to 1. So having a constant amplitude changing our frequencies from your kilohertz to some hertz range, then it producing a constant outputs. The frequencies cannot be changed, the amplitude is cannot be changed, the frequency only changed, that is modulus A beta is equal to 1. Then modulus A beta is less than 1 is simply called as an exponential decaying oscillator. These are simply called as exponentially decaying oscillator. So what is the reason behind that means? So when we the modulus A beta, we are framing our own circuit. In that circuit you are connecting our CRO, then it will display our outputs. So our amplifier gain as well as our feedback factor is less than 1 value, that is in some 0.5 or some 0.6 means. So at that time we are getting output as an this exponentially decaying output. Our amplitude is decreased 1. So first initially having amplitude as an 2 volt, for example I say the 2 volt, then after changing our frequencies, then that will be decreased 1, then 0.5 and 0.6, then 0. Likewise, it will be decreased. So that's why as I'm saying is that it's called exponentially decaying oscillators. Depending upon the A and then beta, the oscillator output will be desired. So likewise having three types under this, depending upon this A beta. So that is the condition of oscillator. Then next, I'm going to explain about RC oscillator. RC phase shift oscillator. So see this diagram. So in this diagram, here having an C and then R, this is a RC phase shift oscillator. So only the circuit presence of R and C components. This is connecting in three networks. This is in three ladder format. So each and every RC network produces 60 degree phase shift. So this first RC network produces 60 degree phase shift, and second RC network produces 60 degree, then third RC network produces 60 degree. So totally 180 degree phase shift. So totally it produces an 180 degree phase shift. Now normally 180 degree phase shift means that, so you're having original sine wave here having an original sine wave. So here original sine wave is here. So this original sine wave is inverted one. 180 degree phase shift means inverting of this input. So that is a 180 degree phase shift. Then next move on to the derivation of the frequency of oscillator. So in this, the amplifier producing a 180 degree phase shift. Here, this amplifier produces 180 degree phase shift. So the output is an inverted one. Then again, this will be given, the amplifier output is given to this RC network. Then that will generate an 180 degree phase shift. That is given a input to your amplifier. So here, this R3, this R through this, it will be sent back to the, this output is oscillator output is given to this input of the amplifier. So simply you are calling as a feedback. This acted as a feedback. This oscillator is acted as a feedback. So already having an inverted output that is given a input of your amplifier. So normally amplifier is what will do. So that shifting 180 degree shift of the input. So that here having an inverted input. So finally it produces an original output. So what is our input is here given? Finally it producing an original output. Here having 180 degree amplifier, 180 degree phase shift. So that will be added with your here you are given a positive feedback. So that is added to your RC network. RC network that produces 180 degree phase shift. So totally it consists of 360 degree phase shift. 360 degree phase shift. So that's why it satisfy our oscillator condition. So total phase shift around the loop is in 360 degree or 0 degree. So here the phase shift is in 360 degree. So it satisfy our oscillator condition. So it is called oscillator. It satisfy our Bergeson criterion. So in this derivation, let's move on to the derivation. So in this derivation, I am going to prove modulus A beta is equal to 1. So draw the equivalent circuit for this circuit. In this, for a transistor circuit, draw the equivalent circuit. So these are equivalent circuit. So for a base, then collector and then emitter, our input resistance HI R1 and then R2 is simply called as an input resistance HI, and our current gain we are calling as HFE IB. So normally our output current is IC is equal to HFE into IB. HFE is nothing but current gain. So HFE is equal to IB. IC by IB. HF is equal to IC by IB. So from that our IC, output current IC is equal to HFE into IB. Then RC resistance. This is our collector resistance, RC resistance. That's we are simply writing as an HOE, output resistance. HOE is called as an output resistance. And this is our three resistance, R and then R. And then this simply called as an R3. Then capacitors, three RC network. Then next one is a modified form of our oscillator circuit. So we are applying a current here, current and then voltage here. So we are applying current to this loop. Then the modified equivalent circuit is changed like this. So our HFE, IB and then RC, our collector current RC, collector resistance. Here our RC is equal to KR. So that is constant. HIE plus R, input resistance R1 and R2 is simply called as an HIE. So HIE plus our R3 is equal to R. Here HIE plus our output resistance R3 is equal to simply our taken as an R. So our constant K is equal to RC by R. So here we are taking that RC resistance RC is equal to KR and capacitance 3 RC network through this current flow. So here considering the three loops, loop 1, loop 2 and then loop 3. So first loop is an I1 and second loop I2 and I3 current. In a polarity you have to represent in terms of polarity. So this is in form of minus and then plus direction. So current is in this directions, forward direction. So plus and then minus, and capacitance plus minus, then plus minus. Then here the current directions, through this current direction we apply. Simply this is a simplified equivalent circuit. So in this we have to apply KVL to find the frequency of this oscillator. In this you have to find F is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC root 6. We have to prove in this derivation with the concept of A beta is equal to 1. Modulus A beta is equal to 1. Using this one, we have to prove this derivation. So apply KVL to this loop 1 and loop 2 and then loop 3. So applying KVL to this loop 1, then getting minus HFE, IB, RC. Then here minus current flow is an I1 current. So minus I1, RC. Then minus 1 by the reactance of your capacitance is minus 1 by J omega C I1. Then minus I1R and here plus I2R. Having and the resistance is, this resistance is present across the current I1 and then I2. So here I1R as well as I2R presence equal to 0. Then replace our RC by an KR. So here the RC is changed with your KR. Then I1 RC. Then minus 1 by, plus 1 by J omega C I1 plus R into I1 minus I2 is equal to minus HFE IB and then RC. In this we have to multiply with an negative sign. Negative sign, so that's why here minus is present. So I1 kr then plus 1 by j omega c I1 plus I1 r minus I2 r is equal to minus h f e I b kr. Then common terms you have to take outside. Here I1, 3 I1 terms is in common. So I1 of k plus 1 r plus 1 by s e minus I2 r is equal to minus h of e I b kr. So consider this an equation 2. Sorry, equation 1. Then apply KVL to your loop 2. So in a current I2. So if you are applying KVL to I2 means, so you are getting minus 1 by j omega c I2, then minus I2 r and minus I2 r, then the resistance is across the I3 as well as I1 current. So plus I3 r and plus I1 r is equal to 0. Then commonly I2 is present in two terms. So commonly take outsides. So minus 1 by j omega c I2 minus I2 r plus I1 r minus I2 r plus I3 r is equal to 0. Then minus I1 r, simplifying this equation, then minus I1 r plus I2 into 2 r plus 1 by SC minus I3 r is equal to 0. So consider this an equation 2. Then apply KVL to loop 3. Here you are applying KVL to loop 3. So minus 1 by j omega c here, then I3, then minus I3 r3, then here minus I3 r, then this r is present across this 2 current, I2 current as well as I3 current. So plus I2 r is equal to 0. So you are getting this equation. You are simplifying this one. Minus 1 by j omega 3 I3 minus I3 r minus I3 r plus I2 r. Then commonly I3 is in. So subtract, sorry, here multiply with a negative sign. So the equation is changed as 1 by j omega c I3 then plus I3 r plus I3 r plus I2 r. Then I3 is common outside, so I3 into here 2r is present, so 2r plus 1 by SC, then remaining one term minus I2r is equal to 0. Consider this an equation 3. Here have to simplify this 3 equation. So through this 3 equations we are getting 3 equation by solving this circuit. So we are using a Gramer's rule to find an output current, that is output current is IC. Here you are called output current as an I3. Normally output current is I3, so here called as I3. So using Gramer rule to solve an I3. So D is equal to, have to find determinant having I1, I2 and then I3 currents. So D is equal to, equation 1 is written in your row 1 and then equation 2 written in your row 2 and then equation 3 is in your row 3. Then this is an I1, this column 1 is considered as an I1, column 2 is an I2 and column 3 is an I3. So here the I1 is in your equation 1 is k plus 1 r plus 1 by sc and then I2 is minus r and I3 is not present, so 0. Then in equation 2 minus r, I1 is minus r and I2 is 2r plus 1 by sc and I3 is minus r. And for your third equation, so I1 is 0, not presence of I1, so 0, then minus r and then 2r plus 1 by sc. Then solving this determinant, you are finding a determinant. So first one k plus 1 r plus 1 by sc, then we are cross multiplying this one 2r plus 1 by sc, then minus r squared, then minus of r, next one minus of minus r. So this is from, you have to leave this two ones, then this minus r into 2r plus 1 by sc, then 0. Then so simplifying this equation, then here for a third row 0, so it will be made as 0. In this matrix, 0 into anything is an 0. So through finding this, solving this matrix, we are getting this value. Then SRC, are simplifying this one. So taking LCM here, SRC. So K plus 1 plus 1 by SC. Then this 2 SCR plus 1 whole square by SC. Then minus R square 2R plus 1 by SC here. SCR plus 1 divided by SC. So minus R square here. Then next here, minus r square into 2r plus ac. Then simplifying this equation, further simplifying this one. So this src is multiplied this one because this is in product one. So src k plus src plus 1 divided by sc. Then here have to expand with an a plus b whole square formula. So a square plus b square plus 2ab. So a square 4 r square s square c square plus b square is an 4 scr plus 1 divided by s square c square. Then this one. So minus r square. So divided by SC, then minus R squared plus this term. Then simplifying this one. So multiplying with this term. So 4 k r cube s cube c cube plus s r c k plus 4 k r square s square c square then plus 4 r cube s cube c cube plus s r c then 4 s square c square r square. So we are multiplying this each one here. Then divided by s cube c cube s c and then s square c square. Then minus this two terms having second and three terms. So this also multiplied the two, this one, because having commonly sc, so multiply the this two terms. Then simplifying this one, so here the common terms is taking outside, s cube c cube and r cube is in common one, so 4k here also having, so 4k plus 4 then plus s square c square r square, so 4 having an s square c square in two terms, so 8, so 4 plus 4 plus 4k then plus src k plus 5 plus 1 divided by s cube c cube, then remaining this term. So then simplifying this equation, so we are getting this value. Finally, you are getting the d is equal to s cube r cube c cube into 3k plus 1 plus s square r square c square into 4k plus 6 plus src of 5 plus k plus 1 divided by s cube c cube. So we find the value of d. Then next, you are going to find an i3. Going to find current i3. So for that, we find d3. So d3 is equal to, for finding i3, so i3 is equal to d3 by d. So already find the value of d. Then next, we are going to find a d3. So d3 is, we have to replace in i3, in that matrix, in that i3 column, we have to replace with a constant value. Here our constant is in minus hf e ib or ck. So minus hf e ib or c or k. So rc is replaced with a constant term rk. Okay. So 0, 0. Here d3 is equal to, here our find this, solve this matrix, we are getting this value. So remaining, we are getting 0, remaining matrix. So first row having a value 2r plus 1 by sc. This is 0, this also 0, then this only minus hf ib rk into here minus r square. So minus minus is a plus, so plus r square. This 2r plus sc is multiplied with 0 means 0. So we are getting d3 as a minus k hf ib r3. Then to find i3, next find i3. So i3 is equal to d3 by d. So d3 value is then minus k hf ib r3 and d is that this value. Already find this one d. So simplifying this one, then we are getting i3 is equal to minus k hf ib r3 s cube c cube divided by this term s cube c cube r cube into 3k plus 1 plus s square c square r square of 4k plus 6 plus src 5 plus k plus 1. Then so next we are going to find mod less a beta is equal to 1. So for this, a is an amplifier gain, beta is an feedback factor. So beta is nothing but output of your feedback circuit to the input of your feedback circuit. So what's our output of your feedback circuit is i3, and input of our feedback circuit is an ib. So that is hf ib. Then for amplifier is an output of amplifier circuit to the input of our amplifier circuit, normally gain means. So output of our amplifier circuit is an i3, input of our amplifier circuit is an ib. So that is, yeah, simply called as an hfe. HFE is called as IC by IB. So IC is also called I3. In this circuit, they are called I3. So A beta is equal to, A beta is a product of A and B. So here beta is I3 into divided by HFE into IB, and then A is nothing but HFE. So HFE into I3 by HFE IB. So A beta is equal to I3 by IB. So to apply this I3 and then IB, we are getting this value. Then S is equal to J omega. So then substituting this one, we are getting this value. So we are finally are getting, so in this equation we replace with an alpha is equal, replace with an J omega with S. Then after that we are getting this equation omega RC. So in this 1 by omega RC we are considering as an alpha, then we are replacing with 1 by omega rc as an alpha. Then finally you are getting alpha cube minus 4k alpha minus 6 alpha is equal to 0. So in this consideration, angle is equal to 0. So that's why this term is 0. So simplifying this one, we are getting 1 by omega rc is equal to root 4k plus 6. So you already know omega is equal to 2 pi f. So 2 pi f, so to apply this one, 2 pi f is equal to 1 by rc, omega is equal to 2 pi f. So 2 pi f is equal to 1 by rc root 4k plus 6. So f is equal to here 1 by 2 pi rc into root 4k plus 6. So this is the frequency of our rc phase shift oscillator. So for a k, so if you are finding a k values, depending upon this substituting a constant k, the frequency will be varied. So the frequency of the RC phase shift oscillator is 1 by 2 pi RC root 4k plus. So simply we can say it as f is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC root 6. This is the frequency of RC phase shift oscillator. So the advantages of this oscillator is, so it is an simple to design. Then it is an simple to design. So if you are changing in frequencies, depending upon this frequency values, the value will be varied. But for a practical consideration, we cannot be change the frequencies. So that way you are keeping a constant value for this RC phase shift oscillator. Then the disadvantages is that, so here the stability is poor due to the changing the value of our components. So if you are changing R and then C, the frequency will be varied. Due to that some temperatures variations then in that component, so some stability is poor, produce and stability factor is somewhat less, so that's why sometimes the frequency is not in stable, so that's why you are using a fixed frequency. Thank you.